Let's start our review. So the first question is, I would like to go back. After formulating and delimiting the research problem, which of the following will be a priority action for Himaya? So our answer here is it a priority to develop the theoretical framework? Okay, so somebody is answering that you need to conduct a literature search for the topic. Now, what was the acronym that I gave you for the phases of research? What was the acronym that I gave you for the phases of research? So take note that you would have your C, D, A, and D. Now, let's say, for example, that Nurse Himaya is presenting her research in a research conference. What phase is she doing? What phase is she doing? She's doing the letter, okay, the D, okay, the dissemination. Sa mga nagdadalawang isip ng spelling ng dissemination, okay lang yan, di ka nag-iisa sa life. Now, Himaya decides to include only nurses who have a minimum of 3 years of experience as a psychiatric nurse. Which of the following terms refer to this? Your keyword is, she is deciding to include only nurses who have minimum of 3 years experience. Now, what's your keyword there? Sa pagid, no? Sa yes, I will include the minimum. So limit, minimum. What is that? Is that a concept? Is that an assumption? A hypothesis or delimitation? Answer, okay, this is your delimitation. This is your delimitations. If I will ask you, what's another term for that? Blank criteria. If you will be asked, what criteria is being described? That would be your inclusion and your exclusion criteria. Okay, that is your inclusion and exclusion criteria. Okay, try to remember that. Now, when I talk about concepts, give me one definition for concept. Give me one definition for concept. What is a concept? Blank of a theory. Blank of a theory. Very good. Your concept is considered to be a building block of your theory. Write it down. When I say concept, it's a building block of theory. Now, when I say assumption, what are assumptions? What are assumptions? What are assumptions? Okay. Mm-hmm. Belief. When I talk about assumptions, they are statements. No? They are statements that look into the relationship of the concepts. They are statements that look into the relationship of the concepts. One keyword that you can get is statement. Now, hypothesis, two words for hypothesis. What's the two word for hypothesis? Educated guess. And delimitations, your delimitations is another term, blank and blank. Your delimitations is another term. You have the blank and blank. Remove the word deli na because you mentioned scope and. So that will be your scope and limitations. Your scope and limitations. So if you would look at it under the scope and limitations, it actually answers the question who, what, where, when, how. That's the questions that need to be answered in your delimitations. Who will be the respondents of the study? What's the topic about? When is the study will be conducted? Where will the study be conducted? How will the study be conducted? Okay, so that is how you will answer your scope and limitations. Next, the length of service is not associated with the degree of patient safety practices of the staff nurses. What do you call this? Anong uri ng choices this? What do you call this one? Okay, the choices are very obvious. Okay, it's hypothesis. Okay, it's hypothesis. Okay, experimental has nothing to do with this. Exploratory and correlational, these are all types of researches, but this is a hypothesis. Now, applying what we have learned last night, when I say hypothesis, what type of hypothesis is this? Null or alternative? Is this null or alternative? HO or HA? HO or HA? Okay, this is HO. May nakita akong sumagot ng alternative. Tingnan niyo po ito. Not associated. Not associated. It's so obvious. That will be your HO. Okay, that will be your HO. That will be your null hypothesis. Now, is this directional or non-directional? Is this directional or non-directional? So this is also a non-directional hypothesis. A non-directional hypothesis. Now, look at the statement. What type of research do you think is being conducted? What type of research is being conducted? A, descriptive comparative, or B, descriptive correlational? What type of research is being conducted? Descriptive comparative or descriptive correlational? So if you would look at this, guys, associated, so this is a descriptive correlational research. Okay? Now, let's proceed to number 24. Which of the following research design is most appropriate for this study if the aim is to find the relationship between two variables? I think we have answered that in the previous question. So that would be your correlational research. That would be your correlational research. Now, let's talk about phenomenological research. When I say phenomenological, the P study there, is it quanti or quali? Is it quanti or quali? It is, when I say phenomenological, it's quali. Now, let's talk about the five types of qualitative research. Or maybe we can focus on the four types of qualitative research. But before that, recap. When I say quali, naturalistic or positivistic? When I say quali, naturalistic or positivistic? Naturalistic. Is it inductive or deductive? Is it inductive or deductive? It is considered to be inductive. Now, let's talk about the four types of qualitative research. One, your phenomenology. Two, you have your case study. Three, you have your ethnography. And then the fourth one is, what's the fourth one? Charmander. What's the fourth one? Okay, your grounded theory. Okay, your grounded theory. I'm not placing narrative inquiry na in the picture. These are the four main types naman of qualitative research. Now, when I talk about phenomenology, keywords, you would want to have an in-depth understanding of the experiences of the individual. Okay, you need to have an in-depth understanding of the experiences of the individual. Yes, oftentimes that study title would contain lived experiences. That's your phenomenology. Now, when I talk about case study, okay, it usually involves a single case. And when I say case, does it necessarily an individual or pwede siyang isang organization? Is it focused on an individual or pwede siyang isang organization? Sige na, when I say case study, does it need to be an individual patient or pwede siyang organization? Okay, guys, pwede. Basta single or double cases, may that be an organization, may that be an individual patient. But that patient needs to be unique. That patient needs to be unique. Hindi pwedeng mag-case study ng mga usual na cases. Okay? It defeats the purpose. Ethnography. Keyword for ethnography. What's the keyword for ethnography? Okay, culture. Take note of that. Ha? Culture. You would want to have an in-depth understanding of a culture. Now, does it necessarily need to become a ethnic group? Para maging ethnography, pwede bang ethnic group? Dapat ba talagang ethnic group lang? So not necessarily an ethnic group. Huh? So you can do your ethnography. Even, for example, I would want to explore the beliefs and practices of mothers in Iloilo City. That is still ethnography. Even though we are not talking about Eta, even though we are not talking about the Mangyans, that is still ethnography as long as it pertains to culture. So somebody is messaging me behavior. Yes, when you talk about culture, diba? It's the practices, it's the beliefs within a certain period of time. Now, grounded theory. When I talk about grounded theory, its aim is to develop a theory. Its aim is to develop a theory. Now, that being said, for example, I would want to know the progress of the case of cancer who was able to recover despite the fact na sabi ng doktor 2 months lang daw siya mabubuhay, but she was able to survive. What type of study will I go on? What type of study will I go on? That would be a case study. I would want to understand the experiences. I would want to understand the experiences of individuals who experienced COVID-19. That would be phenomenology. I interviewed several participants and I want to know what is the relationship between different concepts. I want to know the relationship between different concepts. Eh, diba pag sinabi natin concept, concept is a building block of the theory. So we are dealing with grounded theory. Okay, we are dealing with grounded theory. Okay? Now, when I talk about qualitative research, another thing that we need to remember is the sampling. Okay, sampling, in other words, how will I be choosing the participants that I will have for this research? No? So, what's the sampling technique here? If you will be asked, random nga ba or non-random? Random nga ba or non-random? The tendency is that it will become non-random. To be specific, what type of non-random sampling are we using? What type of non-random sampling are we using? That would be your purposive. Okay, that would be your purposive sampling. Bakit po siya tinawag na purposive sampling? Because you have your own purpose. You have your own purpose. May gusto ka. So, halimbawa, sasabihin mo, these people should have experienced COVID-19. These people should have been student nurses in a certain private school. These people tend to have, okay? May purpose ka. Yes, thank you for saying that. There is a specific group that you are choosing. That's why it's referred to as purposive sampling. And that's why it's referred to as purposive sampling. Okay, so I hope that that will make you capture na. So, keyword for this question, relationship, that would be correlational. Look at the choices in number 24. If I would want to experiment and determine whether a certain treatment is effective or not, what would I do? Looking at the choices in number 24, I would want to know whether a certain experiment is effective or not. What would I do? Sige na, looking at the number 24 choices, that would be experimental research. That would be experimental research. Okay? No, it's not exploratory. It's experimental. So for exploratory, just think you don't know a thing yet. Bobo ka ngayon, you would want to explore what happened. Okay? Now, let's go to number 25. She plans to interview the site nurse manager about the patient practices of the nurses. What type of sampling that those who happen to be in the conference from where the activity is scheduled? What do you call the type of sampling? Okay? The common example that we would give here is that you would just stand on the flagpole and whoever passes by will be your participant. That is your convenience sampling. Okay, that is your convenience sampling. Okay, somebody is asking about number 24. The keyword there is relationship. Relationship is correlational. Relationship is correlation. Okay, now let me go back to number 25. Guys, if I talk about sampling, there are two main types of sampling. Let's talk about sampling. Di natin yan napag-usapan yesterday. One type is what we refer to as your random sampling. Another type is what we refer to as non-random sampling. So guys, another term for random would be, starts with letter P. Okay, that would be your probability sampling. Another term for random is probability sampling. Now, there are several types here. You have your simple random sampling. You have your systematic random sampling. You also have your stratified random sampling. You also have your cluster sampling, and then you also have your multi-stage sampling. Okay? Simple, systematic, stratified, cluster, multi-stage sampling. Okay? Do not write anything. Just try to listen first on my questions before you would write. Let's say, for example, that I would want to conduct a study in Asia. I chose the countries, Singapore, Philippines. In Philippines, I chose one region. In that specific region, I chose one province. In that specific province, I chose 10 municipalities. From each of these municipalities, I chose a barangay. What type of study will, what type of sampling will I be conducting? Your answers, please. Okay, that would be your, try to think. If you would look at it, I came from the national level, I went to the regional level, provincial level, going towards the municipal level. What is it? That's your multi-stage sampling. That's your multi-stage sampling. Okay, bear that in your minds. Now, let's say, for example, I would want to conduct a study in Iloilo City. From Iloilo City, I listed all the 150 barangays in Iloilo City and randomly pick 10 barangays. From the 10 barangays, all of those people in that barangay became my respondent. What do you call that type of research? That's your cluster sampling. That's your cluster sampling. Okay? Now, another example. I conducted a study in a university, and then I went to a college of nursing, and then I chose one section per year level to be the representative of my research. One section per year level to be the representative of my research. Wag mo nang sumagot, mag-isip. Mag-isip. One section per year level to be my respondents. Okay? And then all of those from that section became my respondents. That's still cluster sampling. Huh? That's still cluster sampling. When you say, guys, cluster sampling, you pick a group and then all the members of that group become my respondents. That's still cluster sampling. Are you getting my point? Getting my point? Okay, sige. Now, let's go to simple, stratified, and systematic. When I talk about simple, you use your fishbowl. Okay, simple guys, you use your fishbowl. Huh? So, base karon baka naman mamaya yung fishbowl lang yung hahanapin nyo. So, there are many ways of doing that. No? You can place the name on the cards, you pick the cards, you do the table of random numbers, that's still simple random sampling. Lottery is still simple random sampling. Don't use the term snowball here. Snowball class would go to non-probability sampling. Yes, roulette could also be simple random sampling. Okay? Basta ang punto dyan is that randomly you're picking names. No? Randomly you're picking names. That's your simple random sampling. Now, systematic. Dice. Yes, dice. You could also do that. Systematic random sampling. There's a term there in mathematics. Every blank. Every blank. Yes, stat books would say every KTH. Every KTH. How do you determine it? No? How do you determine it? What's the formula to determine the KTH? There is a formula. No, it's not Slovins and Lovins Paged. It's not Slovins. KTH. I'm talking about KTH. Slovins formula is not anymore acknowledged, but your Slovins formula is used for sample size computation. Okay? Now, what's the formula for KTH? Your formula for KTH is N over N. Okay? Small N over big N. Small N over big N. Okay? Now, what would I do? For example, my big N is, when I say big N, what's big N muna? When I say big N, what's big N muna? What does it represent, students? Future nurses, it represents your population. When I say small N, what does it represent? When I say small N, what does it represent? The sample size. So let's say, for example, out of 200, I will be picking, let's say, for example, 50. Okay? Pag medyo bobo pa sa math, sanayin ang self na gagamitin ang calculator na dadalhin during the board exam. Okay? Pindot-pindot na. Don't use your cell phones. Don't use your cell phones. Use the calculator that you will be using for the board exam if bobo sa math. Pag matalino sa math, huwag kang assuming girl. Gamit ka na ng calcio. Board exam yan. Ha? Board exam yan. O, 200 divided by 50. That would be? 200 divided by 50. That would be 4. Okay? So class, it means every fourth. Every fourth. Okay? So guys, pag may listahan ako from 1 to 200, if may listahan ako from 1 to 200, I would choose every fourth. I would choose every fourth. Now, where will I start? Will I start with number 1 or will I have a random start? Will I start with random 1, with number 1 or will I have a random start? Okay? So you need to have a random start. You need to have a random start. Okay, isipin nyo class that you need to have a random start. So, paano ng random start? Close your eyes, tapos think of him, joke. Close your eyes, guys, tapos point kung saan siya pipigil. So, for example, close ko, eyes ko, okay, drop. It's there on number 4. It's there on number 4. Okay? So, guys, since sa number 4 siya, number 4 is the respondent. 1, 2, 3, 4. Number 8 is a respondent. 1, 2, 3, 4. Number 12 is a respondent. Okay? Kasi nga guys, every KTH and the KTH that we have is every fourth. Okay? Sa nag-PM sa akin, hindi po siya small N over big N po sa taas over small N. It's big N over small N. That's how you would determine your KTH value. Okay? Sige. Same sa ginahimo ko sa pre-boards. Close your eyes and pick sa choices. Bawal yan. Hindi yan stratified random sampling. Okay? Hindi yan systematic random sampling. Now, stratified. The keyword there for stratified is that dalawang keyword lang. Strata, and then you would have proportionate. Strata, and then you would have proportionate. Okay? So, strata, and then you have proportionate. Now, when you say strata, what do you mean by strata? Anong ibig sabihin ng strata, guys? When I say strata, what do you mean by strata? Groups, no? Groups. May stratum. Oo, singular of strata is stratum. Okay? There are groups, no? For example, College of Nursing, level 1, level 2, level 3, level 4. Let's say, for example, there are 100 students in level 1, 200 students in level 2, 300 students in level 4, and then 400 students in level 4. That will be your big N. Now, we need to compute for the small N. So guys, ang punto lang naman ng stratified random sampling is that kung marami ang level 4 sa big N, dapat marami rin ang level 4 sa small N. Okay, again, the point is that if there are a lot of level 4 in big N, there should be also a lot of level 4 in small N. That's why I mentioned the term proportionate, meaning the sample size should be proportionate, okay, with the actual number. So how do we determine that? Sige, go back tayo sa computation ng sample size para ma-review kayo. Give me that Slovens formula that you are talking about. Give me that Slovens formula that you are talking about. Because that's among the most common naman na sampling formula. Anybody? Type. 10. 9. 8. Wow, you like that. Okay? So N is equal to big N over, okay, 1 plus N E squared. Okay, tama ba? So small N is equal to big N all over 1 plus N E squared. Sa mga bago na nakakita nito, oy, gising na. Okay, now let's have the big N. Let's have the big N. 100, 200, 300, 400. Oh, calc you. 100 plus 200 plus 300 plus 400. Answer? Bagal, uy. Okay, 1,000. Sige. Our big N daw is 1,000. Okay, big N is 1,000. Okay, over 1 plus 1,000 times. Where would I get E? What is E muna? What is E? What is E? Salamat, macho dancer, sa paghabol ng formula. Okay, very good. Your E is your margin of error. Your E is your margin of error. May nagsabi na na E is 0.05. Is it 0.05 always? Is it 0.05 always or not? Hindi, no? So class, pwede siyang 0.01, pwede din siyang 0.001. In social studies, what is acceptable? In social studies, what is acceptable? Pwede din pala yung 0.10. Okay? In social studies, what is considered to be acceptable? Social studies, yung mga pa-survey, what's considered to be acceptable? Okay, guys, your 0.05 is already considered acceptable for social studies. Your 0.05 is already acceptable for social studies. Ayos? Now, pag pharmacologic studies, pharma needs drugs. Ano dapat? What's the level that is acceptable? Okay? I would like to correct myself. In reflection, hindi pala ito common. Itong tatlo ang pinaka-common, guys. 0.10, 0.05, and 0.01. Sorry for the confusion. Now, given that three choices, ano po yung maganda para sa drug studies? What's recommended for the drug studies? You would want your 0.01. So 0.01 is recommended for your drug studies. Okay? Let's convert to percentage, no? Sa mga hindi pa math wizards dyan, kagaya us, joke lang. Okay, guys, 0.10, how many percent is that? 0.10, how many percent is that? Okay, 10%, ha? So sa mga lito-lito pa dyan, 10% po yan. Now, 0.05, how many percent is that? 0.05, that would be your 5%. Your 0.01, that would be your 0.01, that would be your 1%. So tama to, tama kanina yung sinabi for the drug studies, you would just allow 1% margin of error. You can just allow 1% margin of error. Now, mag-interpretation pa to. Last time, lumabas din to sa board examinations, no? May interpretation yan. What does a margin of error of 0.005 means? What does a margin of error of 0.05 means? Sige, gawa-gawa mi ng choices. A, 5% of chances that it is accurate. Hirap gawa ng choices kapag sulat-sulat. B, if the study will be repeated 95 times, 5% will be accurate. Okay? C, hirap talaga gawa ng choices. If the study will be repeated 100 times, the result is most likely to be the same 95 times. Answer. Deep breathing muna ako, kapagod magsulat. Okay? Very good. Somebody chatted me. Letter C, kasi yun yung mas mahaba. Actually, guys, one pitfalls of the teachers, according to research, is to place the answer in letter C. Because they don't want it to be in A because it's too early. They don't want it to be in B because it's too early. But they also don't want it to be in D because it's too late already. Yes, that's why C for Christ actually has a research basis. No? I've read that from researchers. Ha? Huwag kayong hindi yan gawa-gawa ng lamang. Ha? Okay, guys. Ha? So that's the message. If the margin of error is 5%, if the study will be conducted 100 times, we are 95% sure that we will get the same results over and over again. Okay? If 100 times ko siyang inulit, 95 times for sure, that will be the result. Okay? Anong pinag-uusapan natin? Stratified random sampling. Okay, let's go back. So for this one, I will use 0.5 squared. Okay? Guys, that is given in your board examinations. Ha? That is usually given in your board examinations. Oh, kalkyo-kalkyo na. Let's compute the denominator first. Let's compute the denominator. So, since gamit yung nakalkyo, baka walang squared. So, you would do 0.05 times 0.05 times 1,000 plus 1. What is our denominator, guys? What is our denominator then? Denominator muna. 1,000 over? Uy, pagka-slow nyo naman, nagka-calcio na nga. 1,000 over? 1,000? Scientific calculators are not allowed during the board examination. Okay, scientific calculators are not allowed during the board examination. 1,000 divided by 3.5. Okay, 1,000 divided by 3.5. Oh, divide-divide na. Divide-divide. 1,000 divided by 3.5. And the answer is, okay, wag mo nang magdiretso sa 285. 285.7. Okay? 285.7. Now, kadalasan, choices yan sa board exam. A, 285. B, 286. C, 287. D, 288. Answer? Answer? 286. That will be letter B. That would be letter B. Okay, you round it off. Yes, that's the rule. Round off. Okay? So guys, we agreed na dapat kailangan natin ng 286 na sample size. So what would I do? That's why guys, you buy your iPads na para makaresize lang kayo kapag yung papel di magkasya. So the total is 286. Total is 286. Okay? So guys, maglagay ng percentage here. And then the total for this one is 1,000. What would you do? Determine muna the percentage. Okay? 100 divided by 1,000. How many percent is that? 100 divided by 1,000. How many percent is that? 10%. No? 10%. Okay? Pagkatapos, guys, your 10% i-multiply ninyo sa 286. The 10% you multiply to 286. That would give you 28.6. Okay? Oh, dahil matalino tayo sa math, diretsahan na yan. 10, 20, 30, 40%. Tapos class 20% times 286. That would give you 557.2. Let me see, 286 times 0.2, yes, 57.2. Then 286 times 0.3, that would be 85.8. 286 times 0.4, that would give you 114.4. Okay? Now, let's see, let's round off. 29, then that would be 58, that would be 86, that would be 114. Eh, tapos i-recheck lang ang total kung nag-match siya. 29 plus 58 plus 86 plus 114. Again, 29 plus 58 plus 86 plus 114. Okay, kung titingnan nyo ang total, 287. Ay, sorry, nagkamali ako. Okay, thank you guys. Okay, so this one is indeed 57. Okay, thank you for the correction. And that's also the same way. Bakit ko siya tinototal para ma-counter check natin kung tama siya. Okay? 286. Okay? Thank you. Now, in that case guys, sometimes hindi magmamatch ang total, so depende dito mag-a-adjust ka. Okay? Now, tip for the board examinations. For example, in my case, I know mathematics, I love mathematics. But if you will ask me, did I use calculators during the board exam? Yes. Because I need my brains for other things, not for the calculation. Okay? Because I am to be tested as a nurse, not to be as a mathematician. So hindi na ako nag-i-effort na mag-manual because my calculator is there with me. Okay? Ilang calculations lumabas sa board exam namin? 3 or 4. Uy, di daw pwede calculate sa inyo? Talaga? You try to verify that. As far as I'm concerned, pwede yung calculator. Okay? As far as I'm concerned, you try to read your NOAA. Your NOAA should contain the instructions. No? Your NOAA should contain the instructions. And that calculator should be non-programmable. The term there is non-programmable. And when you say non-programmable calculators, hindi siya scientific calculator because PsyCalc could be programmed. Okay? So going back here to the random sampling techniques that we are talking about, guys, bakit eraser? So guys, pag sinabi kong stratified random sampling, the message there is that proportionate ta. Proportionate ta. Okay? So when you say proportionate, tingnan nyo, mas marami ang 400, kaya 114 talaga yung sample size from them. Mas maliit yung 100, kaya 29 lang ang sample size from them. Okay? I hope you understand that because even understanding that, if kulang na yung time mo, you will be able to make an educated guess. Okay, now, let's review random sampling techniques. Nurse A used the table of random numbers. What type of sampling technique is it? Nurse A used the table of random numbers. What type of sampling technique is it? Random. Ano ang type ng random sampling technique? What type of random sampling technique is it? That will be your simple random sampling. Okay, that will be your simple random sampling. Now, the individual nurse determined every KTH. The individual nurse determined every KTH. That would be your systematic random sampling. The nurse ensured that there will be more participants from barangay A because they have a bigger population. Ensure that there will be more participants from barangay A because they have a bigger population. Stratified random sampling. The nurse ensures that the male and female will be represented proportionately. The male and female will be represented proportionately. What do you call that? What do you call that random sampling technique? Still your stratified random sampling. Okay, so I hope that you will be able to capture it with that. Now, for the non-random sampling, meron po tayong tinatawag na purposive. Meron din tayong tinatawag na convenience. Meron din tayong tinatawag na quota sampling. Ano pa ba? I think those are the most common. Okay, my question muna, sir, anong definition ng cluster? You choose one cluster. From a certain group, you choose one cluster. And that cluster could be a barangay, that cluster could be a section, that cluster could be a year level. Okay? Sige. Okay. I see. Pa-confirm ha? Pa-confirm ako guys kung pwede ba talaga kayo ng calculator. I think the review center will be able to respond on that properly. I will also try to ask others who were able to take the board exam last time. Okay? Where na me? Okay, guys, look at that. Purposive convenience quota. Let's say, for example, the nurse, ha? The nurse, ay, sorry, na-distract. Sabi dito ng isa, pwede daw ara sa ginhatag sa PRC. I took a board exam recently. I also received the same paper from PRC, but we were not allowed to use calculators in our board exam because our major is not mathematics. So we were not allowed to use calculators. Okay, so the pamphlet kasi is for general. It's not specific for the board exam. Is it? Does the pamphlet say specific for the board of nursing? I think no, because I think we received the same paper when I took the board exam this year too. Okay, so yeah. So best to verify it na lang with the review centers. Alangan naman tatawag kayo sa PRC. Sige na, let's go back here to the three choices that I have. The nurse went to the school and then said to herself, I need to have 50 participants. What type of sampling is that? Look at the three choices on the screen. What type of sampling is that? Yes, it's quota. Nag-set siya ng quota. Now, the nurse stood in the bar. And then whoever is entering the bar will be the respondent of the study. What type of research is that? Convenience sampling. The nurse set the exclusion criteria. What type of sampling is that? That would be your purposive. Now, I approach person A because I know person A has HIV. Then after that, I ask person A, hey, person A, sino pa dyan? Kilala mong may HIV? Sabi niya, oh, ito si person B tsaka si person C. And then I ask the same question to my next respondent. Very good. That will be your snowball sampling. Okay, that would be your snowball sample. Okay, where's my pen? Yes, thank you. That's the keyword, referral. Okay, so anong pinag-uusapan here? She plans to interview about the patient with sampling those who happen to be in the conference room. That's the word, those who happen to be in the conference room. Okay, that would be your convenience sample. Okay. Nurse Ibarra is analyzing a research article. Siya nang maraming time. What section in the article can she expect to find the research question and the study purpose? Now, let's talk about the format first. What's the common format for the abstract? What's the common format for the abstract? That would be your IMRAD. Very good. Your IMRAD. Somebody answered IMRAD last night, right? So, IMRAD. So, I, introduction. Sige, what's the meaning of IMRAD? Keyboard attack. Faster, intro, yes. M, methods, good. R, results, analysis. D, discussion. Okay. Now, where would I find the objectives of the study? Saan ko makikita ang objectives of the study? That would be in the introduction. Okay, that would be in the introduction. Where would I see the different statistical tools used? Where would I see the different statistical tool used? That would be in the methods. Where would I see whether ethical guidelines were followed? Where would I see whether ethical guidelines were followed? That would be in ethics. Uy, ha, discussion lang kayo dyan. Sinong advisor? Okay? Ethics class would be in methods. I would want to know about the research design. I would want to know about the research design. That would be in methods. I would want to know whether there is a significant difference. I would want to know whether there is a significant difference. Ah, significant difference na nga. Okay? That would be in your analysis. Okay? That will be in your results, analysis, and discussion. Yes, that would be in your analysis. I would want to know whether the study is congruent with other findings. I would want to know whether the study is congruent with other findings or contradictory. That would be already your discussion. That would already be your discussion. Guys, results and analysis, they usually go hand in hand. Results and analysis, they usually go hand in hand. Okay, 27. Ibarra, wait lang, anong sagot natin here? Introduction. Ibarra is looking for a description of the type of measurement used in the study. Description daw ng type of the measurement used in the study. Saan ko yun makikita? That would be in the methods. Very good. Okay? Now, description of the type of measurement. So that is where your questionnaire already would come in. Okay. Pikachu. What do you call a brief explanation of the data collection and analysis procedure found in which section of the article? What do you call a brief description of the data collection and analysis procedure? That would be your abstract. And according to APA, how many words? According to APA, how many words? That would be your 250. Okay, 150 to 250. Nurse Ibarra wants to go over the list of references used in the study, which can be found at? Where can I find that? Where can I find that? Okay, so guys, current guideline says it is at the end of the article. At the end of the article. But when I talk, okay, that's number 29, huh? But let's say, for example, the question is citation. Where can I find the citations? Answer, okay, that would be in the literature review. Okay, letter C, if the question is about citations. Now, be careful, huh? In the board examinations, if there are repeat questions, don't expect that the answers would be repeated. Okay, again, if there are repeat questions, don't expect repeat answers also because they are not actually repeat questions. Okay, very rare na may nagkaka-repeat question. And then the way that I knew top notchers, hindi po sila nagre-rely sa mga repeat questions. Bringing inside the examination, books, notes, review, coded data, formula, calculators, programmable calculators, cellular phones, the act shall be considered cheating and act of dishonesty. Ouch! 1996. Okay. Ah, I see. Okay. So, I think pwede yung calculator. Ay, i-share ko, naka-direct message ka pala. Okay, i-share ko sa kanila in all and all. Okay, since you mentioned that, guys, here's the thing, ha. Don't expect already your boyfriend and your girlfriend to go there in the area and then to bring food to you. Okay? You better be sure that by the time you enter the area, you already have the food that you need. Please bring candy. Please bring water. But then, class artista kayo sa araw na yan. So, yung candy and water nyo, dapat walang packs. Ha? Dapat hindi siya nasa pack. Dapat wala siyang label. Diba? Kapag artista, bawal mag-endorse. Maliban na lang kung ikaw talagang endorser. Ha? You need to remember that. Ha? So, bawal ang may mga labels and dapat you should prepare water for the entire day. Yes, for example, the candies, you need to repack that on a Ziploc. That's what I do. No? For the water bottle, you remove the label na of the water bottle. I would advise you to bring 1 to 2 liters, especially in 2 days. In the first day, I mean. Huh? Aqua flask, I'm not sure. I've seen people who are using aqua flask, but I'm not sure about that. Watches, bawal yung electronic watch. But I would recommend that you bring your watches because your watch will be able to give you a prompt of the time. Okay? Kaksay ang name sa Aqua Flask. Sayang lang yung pera niyo. Oh, bawal daw yung department uniform. Di ko yan alam. Watches, hindi yan pwede. Kung may name ang battle, bawal yung labels, guys, because they could be read, no? There could be clues there that could help you answer the board examinations. I don't know about the uniform, guys. Ask yun na lang yung review center. Binibigyan yung minang problem. Next, Nurse Ibarra believes that the research is significant in the nursing profession. Hence, the study research is disseminated. This is because research allows A. Let's look at A. Is A correct? Tama ba yung A? Okay. Sige na, I would want to see who's supporting A, kahit reactions lang. Yes, maraming nag-a-agree sa A. Now let's look at B. The scope of nursing to be expanded into areas formerly reserved for other disciplines. What's wrong here? Yes, somebody saying wrong. So anong mali? let me know. Okay? Formerly reserved for other disciplines. It's for them. No? We are not there to invade them. Next, nursing responsibility to be more specifically defined. Okay? Parang ganda din. Okay? So C, parang check din. D, liability within the practice of nursing to be decreased. As nurses, do we have accountability? Do we have accountability as nurses? Yes. And we don't want it to be decreased. No, we need to be accountable of our acts. So D, it's a no-no. Now, if you would look at A and B, torn between two lovers tayo, sino yung mas mahaba? Okay? Letter. Okay, guys, umbrella. Ha? A, umbrella. So the answer is letter A. Okay? Sige. Charmander. Now, ay, bakit may mga documentation here? Which could be the major purpose of the study? Nurse Flora and Imelda are doing research. The common errors regarding standard of nursing documentation, OB ward, medical center. What could be the major purpose of the study? Okay. Ano ang major purpose ng study? Okay. Reduce, if not eliminate daw, errors in documentation. A daw says improve the clarity of documentation. Okay. Let's look at A. Is A correct? Tingnan mo na yung A. Hindi ko gustong mag-jump sa C. Okay lang bang A? So somebody saying correct din naman ng A. Improve the clarity of documentation. Let's go back. Common errors regarding standards of nursing documentation in OB ward. No? So common errors daw. Gusto nilang mag-find out kung ano ang common errors. Okay. B, duplicate the study in other hospitals. Does it talk about duplication of studies? Does it talk about duplication of studies? No, it's not. It does not. C, reduce, if not eliminate, errors in documentation. When I conduct a study, let's say, for example, I will conduct a study, knowledge about dengue fever. Am I increasing right away the knowledge in dengue fever? Am I increasing the knowledge in dengue fever? Think, ha? I conducted a study, knowledge about dengue fever. Tataas ba kaagad ang knowledge ng individuals on dengue fever? No, it would not. No? It would not. It's not the direct goal. Ha? It's not the direct goal. Okay? So, I leave that into question mark. D, protect the hospital and staff from being sued. Is it what you want? No. Okay? So, guys, if you would go back to the definition, what is the main purpose of research? If I would go back to the question, what is the main purpose of research? What is the main purpose of nursing research? What is the main purpose of nursing research? Set aside muna si 31. Ano sabi ko sa inyo? What is the main purpose of nursing research? Improve the delivery of care. Improve nursing care. The word is improve. Okay? So the answer for this one, best answer is letter A. Ha? Best answer is letter A. Okay? Take note of that. When you conduct a study, by the time class that I will say, no, by the time that I will say common errors regarding, hindi naman, it does not mean that I will reduce the errors right away, but surely I will be able to improve the documentation. Okay? Yes, thank you, Saging, for saying major purpose. So that's why it goes back to the literature, goes back to the textbook which asks, what's the major purpose of nursing research? And the answer for that is to improve the quality of nursing care. Now, which of the following could be the best method to gather the research data? Ano po kaya ang best method to gather the research data? Okay? Audit. When I say audit, what do we do? There are types of audit pala eh. There are types of audit. Sige, audit. Somebody is messaging me. Sabi niya daw evaluation. Sige, ano pa? When I say audit, whereas si Sir Nyo, nagsisearch actually ng types of audit. Sige, when I say audit, sige, chat lang kayo dyan kung anong audit and I will see if I have something related to audit. Okay, found it. Where are you? Okay, sige. Ay, very good to. This is a very good definition. So, assessing if at par with standards. Okay, assessing if at par with standards. So, many are answering audit. We can do that. Now, focus group discussion. When I do focus group discussion, what are we doing here? Questionnaire or interview? Questionnaire or interview? Okay, nag-i-interview. Interview individually or per group? by group, no? Interview by group, if you can look at the term. So if you would look at it, if I'm talking about errors in documentation, will they confess if by group siya? Will they confess if by group siya? So the tendency is no. Now, phenomenological. We know phenomenological, lived experience, and we are not talking here about lived experience. So it's still a no. Now, survey. When I talk about survey, your survey is usually used for social issues. For survey, guys, it's used for social issues. So no, this does not involve social issues. So the best answer is nursing audit. Okay, nursing audit. Now, nursing audit. Let me pull out something about nursing audit. Okay. When you talk about nursing audit class, na, so that's the keyword earlier, what your batchmate had paired you for nurses. So audit is actual performance. Take note, ha? Audit is actual performance versus standards. Okay? Audit is actual performance versus standards. Okay? May dalawang major types ng audit. You have your concurrent audit, and then you have your prospective audit. Concurrent, and then, retrospective. Sorry, ha? Concurrent, and then you have retrospective audit. Okay? Do not write anything. Just look at the term. Concurrent, retrospective. Just look at the term. Concurrent, retrospective. Okay? Look at the terms, ha? Do not write anything na. The nurse is doing review of discharge patients. Review of discharge patients. What type of audit is that? Because when I say retro, what is retro nga? You look into the past. You look back. Okay? Now, questionnaires are sent to the patients who went home. Questionnaires are sent to the patients who went home if they are satisfied with the hospital care. That is still retrospective. Now, how about if we review the patient's chart while the patient is still confined? We review the chart while the patient is still confined. Very good. Concurrent. Let's say, for example, we observe the staff as they care for the patient. We observe the staff as they care for the patient. That is still concurrent. Okay? So guys, ha, the answer is actually on the word itself. Okay? So I hope you did not write down anything for that purpose. 33. What is the term used to describe the arrangement of statistical data that exhibit the number of times the values of a variable occurs? Okay. What do you call that? Term used to describe the arrangement of statistical data that exhibits the number of times the values of a variable occur. That would be your frequency. Okay. That would be your frequency. Okay. Skewness muna. There is something in skewness that we were not able to touch. Let me pick a definition first if I can. Okay. With fear. Skewness. Mm-hmm. What do you mean by skewness, guys? What do you mean by skewness? Can anybody give me a keyword for skewness? Skewed. Kainis is you. Okay. Mm. There are two types of skewness, eh. You have your skewed to the left versus the skewed to the right. So you have your skewed to the left versus skewed to the right. So, wait lang ha, I'll pick up something. Medyo natenga tayo sa statistics natin here. Basta guys, when you say skewness, okay, it talks about the curvature versus the normal curve. No? It's a curvature versus the normal curve. So when you say skewed to the left, skewness. Pag sinabi kong skewed to the left, it looks like this. Okay? This is your line that's supposed to be a straight line. And this is your graph. No? This is skewed to the left. In other words, guys, medyo may depression siya sa left side. Okay? Pag sinabi ko namang skewed to the right, it looks like this. It looks like this. That's skewed to the right. Okay? Now, let's have examples, ha? Sorry lang sa akin ng mga drawing, ha? Let's have example. My exam in MS is very easy. My exam in MS is very easy. What's most likely to be the skewness? Skewed to the left or skewed to the right? parang may nagre-reklamo ng very easy. Ah. Okay. Guys, if you are looking at the normal curve, if you are looking at the normal curve, what's the shape of the normal curve, students? Future nurses, what's the shape of the normal curve? It is described to be center-center ka dyan. Curve-curve ka dyan. There's a word for that that starts with letter B. Okay? Parabola ka pa dyan. Hirap niya eh. Okay, very good. That's a bell shape. Na-question naman, sir, bell na. Obviously. Okay, so that will be your bell-shaped curve. Now, guys, if you would look at the bell-shaped curve, these are the lower values here. Okay, that is usually 0. This is negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, and then 1, 2, 3, 4. In other words, the low scores are found here, and then the high scores are found here. Okay? Now, let me go back to the question. My exam in MS is very easy. My exam in MS is very easy. What would be the tendency of the data? Skewed to the left or skewed to the right? Okay? Ah, hindi nakikinig is you. My exam in MS is very easy. What is the tendency? Will it be skewed to the left or skewed to the right? Guys, pag madali yung exam ko, anong tendency sa scores nyo? Mataas or mababa? The tendency is that? Okay? Wait lang, the tendency is that the scores will be high. Okay, the tendency is that scores will be high. So if the scores are high, nobody's getting the low scores, but a lot of people are getting the high scores. So skewed to the left or skewed to the right? That will be... Bakit kayo nagkakamali? Diba, I labeled it here na when I say skewness. Skewness is the slope. Skewness is the part that is depressed. I cannot! Wait lang, I'll take a deep breath. Hey, dali lang. Where did I go wrong? I lost a friend somewhere along the wilderness. Ay, nako. Okay. Mabuti na lang at may iPad tayo. Char. Sige, let's throw that out. Okay. Guys, ah. Okay, guys, empty your brains muna. Okay, on this part. Not everything. Not everything. Ka-empty nyo sa lahat. Dead tayo. Okay. Guys, when I talk about skewness, when I say skewed to the left, look at the drawing ha. Okay, this is skewed to the left. Okay? Now, when I say skewed to the right, this is your skewed to the right. Because the term skew class is where the depression is. The term skew is where the depression is. Okay? Hindi ko nasaan yung bukid, yun yung skewness. Okay? Ay, salamat, salamat. Okay, okay. Parang mapapainom ako ng isang litrong Coke here. Okay? Now, again, I'll go back to my question. My exam in MS is easy. A very easy exam. What will be the skewness? Skewed to the left or skewed to the right? That will be skewed to the left because the graph would look like this. Ayas? Okay. Now, let's say for example, it's floody days, tapos walang makain, and then after the month, I took the weight of the children. Let's say, the weight of kids after calamity. After calamity. What will be the skewness? Skewed to the left or skewed to the right? Okay, so maraming underweight, kaya skewed to the right. Ay, so wakas. We are already on the same page. Thank you, thank you, thank you, guys. Let's give ourselves a clap. Okay? May mga board exam questions din ganun, ha? So, kindly familiarize yourselves with that. So, guys, somebody asked earlier if I saw it right. Somebody is asking about the definition of frequency and then frequency distribution. So, guys, when I talk about frequency distribution, frequency distribution is talking about tables or charts. Ha? Frequency distribution already has tables or charts. Okay? But for this definition, frequency lang siya. Okay, clap yourself. Yan, masanay na din kayo mag-slap ng sarili niyo. Because that's what I do also in the board examinations, especially if I'm already asleep. Okay? Ha? Next. In statistics, what is the definition of percentage? Whole population. Is that statistics? Wow. Yes, man. Okay. So guys, the answer is part of a whole expressed in hundreds. Okay, part of a whole expressed in hundreds. That's letter D. Okay. Now, based on the study findings, to whom are the study's recommendation generally addressed? Using the situation aforesighted, the recommendation should be addressed to. Anong study nga ni? This is about common errors regarding standard of nursing documentation in OB ward. Okay? Now, let's see. Nurse educators. Can nurse educators help in this one? Yes. Staff nurses. Pwede. Hospital nursing administrators. Pwede. Hospital administrators. Okay. I need a second opinion on this one. Okay? Bakit? Yeah, I know all of you are answering all of the above, I can see. Bakit? Let's think. Hospital administrators. Hospital administrators. Common errors regarding standard of nursing documentation in OB ward. Nursing documentation in OB ward. Nursing documentation. Who addresses the nursing problems? No? So it is supposed to be not the hospital administrators na. Huh? Oh, sige. I will not give an answer muna for this one. I'll consult my panel of experts. My panel of experts. Okay? I'll ask muna my colleagues about this. Ha? Okay? They are reliable colleagues naman. So I will try to ask them if what's their take on this. In a while, I'll be sending this muna to them. Sige. So far, learning something? Are you learning something pa naman? I'm opening my messenger. Let me see. Yes. Okay. Sige. Punta muna ako kay. Sana nga ba yung mga colleagues ko? Again, guys, as I appreciate those who message that your answer is all in your drills. Thank you for that, no? But then I could not be convinced that that is because the answer in drills, I will answer the same. Huh? So I need the idea. Answer please. Inaabala man og alas 10 na nga pamangkot kaya. I'm so sorry, I don't have time kasi to look na for the textbooks to answer that one. 36. Comprehensive. Sige ha, suktan niyo nako. Hindi ko nabigay yung situation. Oh, witty talaga yung tinatanong ko. May follow-up question siya. Sabi niya, ano ang situation? And then may pagkabobo din ni, hindi ko binigay ang situation. Wait lang. Okay, there. Sige. Uy, sorry ha, if different individuals would have different answers. O, diba, Delphi technique. Okay, 36. Comprehensive surveys of research report and case study literature about IM injections revealed that administering medications IM can produce a variety of serious effects. When asked by the head nurse what possible complications can arise, Nurse Mimi should include which of the following? IM injection. Pwede bang may skin and tissue trauma? Pwede? Mm-hmm. Muscle fibrosis and contractures. Pwede bang magka-muscle fibrosis and contractures? If I would recall my knowledge in MS, I think that's also possible. Mm. How about nerve palsy and paralysis? Pwedeng mag-paralysis sa IM injection? Especially if you're doing the injection in what part of the body? Especially if you're doing the injection in what part of the body? Okay? Gluteal, no? What muscles would you hit there? What nerve would you hit there? Anong tawag doon? Ay, very good. Sciatica kayo dyan. Sciatica is pain, ha? Sciatica is pain. Sciatic is nerve, ha? Sciatic is nerve. Infectious process such as abscess or gangrene, pwede bang mangyari? Okay, that would be your... Okay, so that will be all of the above. All of the above. Okay, Nurse Mark, assigned onco, tertiary hospital, aware that increased number of colorectal cancer, he and a colleague plan to conduct a study of the incidence of colorectal cancer in the Philippines. Nurse Mark formulates a possible title for the study, which is the most appropriate title. Incidence of colorectal in the Philippines. perception of the Filipino people on colorectal cancer. Colorectal cancer in the Philippines, risk factors, intervention, comparative study on. So our answer for this one is, let me see. Sige. Obviously, that would be letter A. Huh? Obviously, that would be your letter A. Oh, are you having this also in your drills? That's nice. What research design is the most suitable to gather the data for the study? What's the research design suitable to gather the data for the study? Okay. Mm-hmm. Do I need a quasi-experimental here? If I will be asking you quasi-experimental, di ba sabi natin pag-experimental, RCM? Pag quasi, anong nawala? Pag quasi, anong nawala? Nawala yung R, so it's only C and M. Now question, do I have manipulation here? Am I having manipulation here? No, no, no. So it's not quasi-experimental. Relationship, are we talking about relationship? This is also no, no, no. So descriptive, okay? Now developmental, am I trying to develop a module? Am I trying to develop a program here? Okay, so no also. So the answer is descriptive, okay? Now guys, differentiate to me first incidence and prevalence. Okay, differentiate to me incidence and prevalence. When I talk about new cases, when I talk about new cases, what am I talking about? Okay, very good. When I talk about new cases, that would be your incidence. Huh? So incidence, okay? So incidence, where is it? Incidence, guys, we're talking about new cases. Incidence, new cases. Now, when I talk about prevalence, you're talking about old and new. Old and new. Okay. Yes, thank you for that. Sige. In gathering the data, which ethical principles will be followed? Dali naman ito eh. Tikalon. Okay, answer? Lahat. Okay, lahat-lahat lang. Now, Nurse Mark formulates an assumption for the study. Which of the following is most acceptable? When I say assumption, is it already proven? When I say assumption, is it already proven? Okay? No, it's not yet, no? So liver cancer cases decreased in 2017 due to intensive public awareness. Is that an assumption or a fact? Is that an assumption or a fact? That is a fact. Now, more Filipinos, regardless of gender, are diagnosed with colorectal cancer. Okay, letter, bakit may pangapa-thanks po? Anong nangyayari? More Filipinos, regardless of gender, are diagnosed with colorectal cancer. That is a fact. Male Filipinos are prone to colorectal cancer than liver cancer. Male Filipinos are prone to colorectal cancer than liver cancer. Hindi din ako sure. Sige. Anong pulse ang sinusulat? D, the leading cause of colorectal cancer among Filipino is high consumption of alcohol. This seems to be a fact also. No? The way I look at the four statements, they appear to be facts. Now, we are looking at the wrong direction. Let's go back to the question. The question says, ay, di ba na ano nyo na to, Nadrian? Nurse Mark is assigned in the oncology unit. He's aware of the increase in number of the colorectal cancer patients. Incidence of colorectal cancer. So again, let's go back. If it talks about incidence, let's go back to the keyword of incidence. So again, A, does it talk about incidence? Liver cancer. Ha? Diba ang focus natin, colorectal cancer? Am I right? Diba? No? Yung pinag-uusapan natin, colorectal cancer. So natrap tayo dyan. Okay, out ka, out. More Filipinos, regardless of gender, are diagnosed with colorectal cancer. Is this talking about incidence? Is this talking about incidence? Letter B. Yes, it's talking about incidence. No? And then it's also talking about colorectal cancer. C. Male Filipinos are prone to colorectal than liver cancer. If we will pursue the study here, di ba ang study natin is incidence of colorectal cancer? Will we be able to conclude that male Filipinos are prone to colorectal than liver? Hindi, because our study is only talking about colorectal cancer. So C is out. And then D, the leading cause of colorectal cancer among Filipinos is high consumption of alcohol. Are we trying to relate alcohol with colorectal cancer? No also. Bakit pulse? Di ko gets ang pulse. Ano yung pulse? Okay? So guys, the answer for this one is letter B. Okay, we were looking at the wrong direction a while ago. So we need to have an assumption related to the research that we are conducting. Ah, true or false? Okay, sige. Sino nagsabi niyan? Me, nagkamali ng pronouns? Parang na-conscious naman tayo tuloy sa mga ganern eh. Okay? Ay, okay. Low power mode. Ay, may mga low power mode. Mga nasobrahan ng busog yung mga low power mode. You are a nurse manager. Where are we? Which of the following is the most appropriate recommendation Nurse Mark should propose? Okay? 41. Ano kaya yung magandang recommendation? A. Warning signs of the effects of alcohol should be printed. Did we study about alcohol? Did we study about alcohol? No, we did not. Health professionals should educate the public on the risk factors of colorectal cancer. Can we get this if we will learn about incidents? Pwede ba nating makuha yan if we will learn about incidents? Parang pwede. Okay? So lagyan natin ng pwede. DOH only should intensify its campaign on colorectal cancer awareness. What's one word? Nagkamali sa C. Very good. May only. Ay, mahulog nga. Ay, tanan ko pa naman nga ballpen nga mahulog. Okay, sorry. DOH only. Okay? So wrong. Okay, na-fall. Yung maling bagay. D. Congress should pass a bill banning all cancer. Ano naman nagkamali dito? Ano naman nagkamali here? The word? All. Okay? Tapos huyu para dumiretso dun sa Congress. No? For just one study that you did, tawag-tawag kay Congress. So the answer for this one is letter B. Okay? The answer for this one is letter B. First time nag-breakdown para sa ballpen. Of course! Nung ballpen ko na mas mahal pa sa down payment ng tuition. Sir, kapal ng pagmumukha. Boy kayo dyan. Bravo. Okay? Bravo. Boy, magka-graduate na kayo, di pa boy kayo. Okay? 42. Nurse manager, tertiary hospital, one of your responsibilities is to keep a record of all patients admitted in the hospital. Okay? You are aware of the importance of keeping hospital records. Which of the following statement is not true about hospital records? Hospital records? A. Provide data on HIS. Pwede ba? Ang hospital records ba nagpo-provide ng data sa HIS? Yes, it's true. So, ang hinahanap natin is not true. Nagtipid lang sila ka-ink kay tupaday man ng T. B. Are a key source of data for medical research on statistical reports. Pwede ba siyang maging key source of data? Yes. C. Provide personal information about the physician and nurses assigned to the care of the patient. Pwedeng ganon? Yung mga information? Slam book. So wrong. D. Provide evidence of hospital accountability. Yes, no. So letter D is correct. So answer for this one is letter C. Next, you are oriented on the hospital policy that when a patient is readmitted, the patient's file may be retrieved from the records department. From which file may be a readmitted patient's record be retrieved? Okay? Basahin yung last sentence. From which file may be a readmitted record be retrieved? Pwede sa physician's ledger? No. Master patient index file. Pwede kaya sa master patient index file? O use your common sense. Kahit ako, hindi ko to na-meet ang mga files na yan. Okay? But come to think, master patient index file. Master patient index file. Can that contain all of the files about the patient? Pag sinabing master file, di ba? Parang master list. Okay? I think yes. Yeah, dapat ganun kayo mag-isip. Civil service file. Anong civil service file? Huh? Civil service file, walang kinalaman yan. Civil services for the government officials, government workers. Hospital, library records. Kanina, no, marami kayong sumagot ng letter D. So pag pupunta po kayo sa hospital library, ang makikita po ninyo is Brunner and Sudar, Kosher and Herb. Pagkatapos, isabihin nyo na po si kung ano-ano pa dyan. So letter D, kamuda. Okay, master patient index file. Master patient index file. By the way, if a subpoena, what is the subpoena pala that could carry the chart to the court? The subpoena that could carry the chart to the court. Okay, your subpoena duces tecum. Okay, others would say duces tecum. Now, when I say duces tecum, who will be bringing the chart to the court? Who can bring the chart to the court? A, the nurse. B, the medical records officer. C, the lawyer. Eh? Haba, lawyer. I quit, guys. Good night. Sino ang kambal sa inyo nga lawyer? The lawyer could not bring the chart to the court. Ha? Who can bring the chart to the court? A, the nurse. B, the lawyer. C, the medical records officer. Okay, I'll add the physician. And the third D, the physician. Who will bring the chart to the court? That would be the medical records officer. Ha? The medical records officer. Even the doctor in charge of the patient could not bring the chart to court. Sinong nagsabi sa inyong lawyer? Can the lawyer touch the chart of the patient? Can the lawyer touch the chart of the patient? No. Even if it is the patient's lawyer could not touch the chart unless the patient would signify so. Ha? Ay, gising. Eh? Now, if not the medical records officer, give me another official in the hospital who could bring it to court. Eh? Give me another. Not the doctor, not on the choices. Okay? Not the chief nurse. No. It will be the medical director. It will be the medical director. Hospital lawyer lang kayo dyan. Right? What's the other sabina nga? What's the other sabina? I forgot also. Ay, okay. Sabina ad distificandum. Thank you for reminding me on that. What do you call the power of the BON to release subpoena? What do you call the power of the BON to release subpoena? Powerful. Sino naghambal nga admin power kung kugunta ka be? Civil pagid, someone, power of love. What are the three powers of the Board of Nursing? What are the three powers of the Board of Nursing? One, you mentioned admin. Mali yung judicial. Very good. Quasi-legislative. And then another is quasi-judicial. Ha, the three powers of the Board of Nursing. So the issuance of subpoena, where would that belong? Okay, where would that belong? Quasi-judicial. Hoy, hindi Malacanang ang may judicial power. Malacanang would have administrative or executive power, but not judicial. It's the Supreme Court was the judicial power. Okay. Now, how about the making of the Code of Ethics? Where would that belong? Quasi-legislative. Okay, now, sigway gamay. 44. Kayo ha. Huh, where is it? You orient your staff on the common system used in recording the nursing interventions. The system is a nursing index card, also referred to as CARDEX. Okay, also referred to as CARDEX. What information is not included? What is quasi-delix? Somebody is mentioning quasi-delix. What is quasi-delix? There's another term for quasi-delix that starts with letter T. Okay, very good. Torts. Okay, quasi-delix or torts. Okay, going back to 44, what information is not included? Nandyan ba ang drug regimen ng pasyente sa CARDEX? Yes. Allergies ng patient in the CARDEX? Yes. Progress notes of the physician? No. Saan ko to makikita? You'd be able to see that in the, okay, progress notes, or you can see that in the order sheet. Dietary requirements of the patients? Yes, it's there. Now, sige, tama. So the answer for this one is letter C. Now, question, is the CARDEX legally binding? Is the CARDEX legally binding? Oh my God. 90% sumagot ng yes. Sige, magbago muna kayo. Magbago muna kayo, guys. Is CARDEX legally binding? No, it's not. It's not legally binding. So I could not say I administered the drug because it's written in the CARDEX. Okay? So, yes, because it changed, no? In CARDEX, it's not an official document. It's not even part of your chart. So what is considered to be legally binding is still the patient's chart. So if you will be asked, what's your basis for administering the medication? A, CARDEX. B, physician order sheet. C, measurement of intake and output. And D, medication record. What would be your basis? Okay? So guys, even if I'm talking about medications, you don't answer medication record. But it will be the physician order sheet still. That will be the basis of your Medication Administration, not your CARDEX. Ha? So hindi mo pwedeng sabihin, ay sir, ginawa ko yun dahil yun ang sabi ng CARDEX. No and no. Now, 45. The patient records contains information of medications and treatments administered and observation of the condition. Which of the following data must be filled up in the patient's chart when she is discharged from the hospital? When she is discharged from the hospital. Answers? Okay? Huwag nang magpakamali-mali here, ha? Okay? Isasabay ko kayo, boss, on November 1. Letter C. Final medical diagnosis. Why? Religion. Upon admission or discharge? Upon admission or discharge? Admission. Nursing diagnosis. Also admission and ongoing. Educational attainment. Siyempre, upon admission mo yan kukunin. Okay? Now, question. Very common in the board exam. When does the discharge process start? When does discharge process begin? Okay, very good. Upon admission. Ay, makapasar. Bawi-bawi lang kayo dyan. Kasi kanina yung nurse papapuntahin nyo sa korte. Don't know with you. Next, you are familiar with the ethical aspects of patients and hospital records. Which of the following statement is not true? Which of the following statement is not true? A. Health records are the property of the locality where the patient is treated. True ba yan? It's the property daw of the locality where the patient is treated. Nasa na yung mga chat nyo? Nawala ni. A. No daw. Bakit? What's the true there? Huh? Are the property of the locality. Mali daw yung locality. Sige nga. B. Hospital records may be released without the patient's consent when required in investigation for serious criminal offense. True ba yun? Yes, pwede yan. Okay? And that needs to have subpoena also. C. Confidential records must be protected against loss, damage, access, modification, disclosure. True din siya. Next, patients have the right to treatment of information they provide to health professionals. True din ka. Okay? Mali talaga yung letter A. Now, let's talk about the chart. The physical property of the chart belongs to? The physical property of the chart belongs to? Patient-patient kayo dyan. Yung mga hospital, okay, pwede na kayong pumasa. The physical property of the chart belongs to the hospital. Okay? How about the contents of the chart, the information or the contents in the chart that belongs to your patient? Okay? Marites, beginning nurse in a government hospital. By the way, by the time that you graduate, what do you expect yourselves to be? Are you a nurse specialist or are you a nurse generalist? When you graduate, okay, pag specialista na kayo, edi kayo na. By the time you graduate, you're expected to be a beginning nurse generalist. By the way, what are the three roles that you have? May tatlong beginning roles yan eh. May tatlong beginning roles. No? May tatlong beginning roles. Beginning, nurse, tatlo yan. Beginning, nurse, beginner, novice. Hindi. No, based on the competency standards of nursing, the current competency standards of nursing. Beginning, nurse researcher, isa yung beginning nurse researcher. Ano pa? Ay. Ni na si stress, di nyo alam. Di ko rin alam. Diba, paano na lang tayo pag di natin to alam? Okay? Maghanap tayo ng nakakaalam. Beginning, and the end. Sino nakakaalam nun? There are three of those. There are 11 key areas of nursing competencies during our time, but they are grouped into three, no? Sige, i-chat mo daw si sir. Ikaw lang mag-chat. Beginning nurse, try to search. If I'm not, there's beginning nurse researcher, I'm sure about that. No, it's not the love of God, self, and country. That's the old role. Beginning nurse researchers, it's not educator. I think beginning nurse manager is there. Uy, bakit di nyo to alam? At bakit di ko rin alam? I'm starting to question myself na lang rin. Okay? Sige ha, I'll just try to search if meron akong if there's something in the internet about this. Okay, I'm sure beginning nurse researcher is one. Another is beginning nurse manager, I think. Yes, there are three. Oh my God, I hate me for not recalling this. Huh? Sige, remind me on this or try to look into this also. I'm so sorry guys, hindi na kaya ng brains ko yan. Okay? Marites should know that in narrative charting, documentation of the patient care should be narrative charting. When I talk about narrative charting, what are we doing in narrative charting? Is it extensive, formatted, or chronologic? It's chronologic. Okay, so the answer for this one is letter C. Okay, if you would look at it, what's the current standard of DOH in charting? Is it the narrative charting or the focus charting? The current standard of DOH in charting, that would be your focus charting or your FDAR charting. Which statement is not true about the medical records that Marites must understand? Charts, not true ha. Contents must be kept confidential. Tama naman yung A, di ba? B, the charts can be borrowed by any nursing student. What may be wrong? What may be wrong? Okay, any. Uy, by the way, I think this is correct. Okay? Go back. Chicken nuggets. Oh, I love chicken nuggets. Nurse practitioner, nurse researcher, and the nurse leader manager. Okay, I'll get this one. May I know your reference, chicken nuggets? Is this from a BON resolution? Okay. Sorry ha, na-distract ako ni chicken nuggets kasi maganda naman yung information niya. Okay, saan daw yun? Ha? From Dean. Okay. Yes. Okay, yeah, he is discussing that one. Guys, kasi in our time, no, there are 11 key areas of nursing competencies. There are 11 key areas of nursing competencies. And then later on, these 11 key areas was regrouped. And then there are already 3 beginning roles of nurses. There are 3 beginning roles of nurses. And I think you're correct. No? You're correct on saying that it's the beginning nurse practitioner, beginning nurse researcher, and then the beginning nurse manager. Okay, thank you for that. Thank you for the input. Okay, sige. Yes. Role of client care management. Okay, sige. Thank you guys. Thank you for the input and thank you for reminding me on that. So B is wrong because any. C can be accessed by a researcher. Can the chart be accessed by the researcher? Yes. C can be given out only with patient's consent. Then that's yes. So the answer is letter B. Letter B. Okay? So you just watch out for the term there. Any. Now, the following are methods of charting, except the following are methods of charting. Huh? Though hindi ako nakarinig ng sequential, I don't know if you did. Narrative, do we have narrative charting? Yes, we have. Do we have POMR charting? Do we have POMR charting? What's the meaning, by the way, of POMR? If you can orient me again, what's the meaning of POMR? Honestly, I also forgot. Ah, okay, problem-oriented medical record. Hey, thank you. Do you have your focus charting? Yes, you have your FDAR charting. You have your FDAR charting. So yes, we don't have sequential charting. That's A. In the PIE method, P is for needs exact. P is for needs exact. What is exact there? Okay. What is exact A for? Okay. Admission. Do we include admission in the planning? How about P? Problem. Do we include that? Yes, it's there. Teaching is also there in our plan. Discharge is also there in our plan. Okay, so admission is not. So the answer for number 50 is. Okay, it's already 10 on my watch. Okay, ox na. Dasig sang oras ah. 10 na gali. Okay, sige guys. It will be November 1 tomorrow. So spend time with your family. Okay.